Hello students, today we will do civics chapter 1, diversity. See, imagine if we have a garden with only one color of flower and similar sizes. Would we like it? No, we like colorful garden with different color, different variety of flower, different sizes. And imagine if the earth was all same, everywhere plain area, no mountains, no plateaus, no deserts, no oceans, no coastal area. It would have been a boring place. So we always need a change, or we always need to have some change and variety in our life. Imagine if in the Stone Age, man did not discover the things and would have been happy with the things which he was living. Then our life would have been till now like a stone age only. So everyone needs a change and improvement from what is available and existing. So we now need a change in what we have and what is existing. Growth and progress happens as we human beings wish to find new things. So everything will happen, new things will happen in our life. Okay. So this human quality brings about inventions and innovations. When we want change and variety, we will do new innovations and inventions. Meaning of diversity. Just look around in your class. You will find that everyone is wearing the same uniform, yet everyone is different. So now you cannot look around in your class, but you remember your class days, your school days. You all are wearing same uniform, but all of you look different. Your classmates come from different localities and different families. They may follow a different religion like Hinduism, Sikhism, Islam, Jainism or Buddhism. So they may be wearing the same uniform, but they all are of color, different height, different size, from different religion, from different localities, different tiffins they bring. So many things are different. Some come from the hill regions, from the plains of India, from south part of India. They speak different languages at home like Bengali, Gujarati, Marathi, Tamil, Telugu, Hindi, Punjabi, Urdu, etc. So this difference is called diversity. So diversity is difference that you see around you in culture, in language, in dressing up, in food. All that is your diversity. Unity. See, all of you may be different in the class, from different localities, colonies, different religion, culture, speaking different language, but still you all live together as friends. So although the students are from diverse background, different backgrounds, yet you all are friends in the class. Okay, and you are of same section, maybe in class 6th, any one section you become friends. You may be from different localities and colonies and religion. So your classmates, you study together, you play together, have debates, competitions, games with other sections, some competition, and you are united. Thus you are united together as one even while you are from diverse backgrounds. So in class, you all are united together though you are different. In a nutshell, this is what unity in diversity means. That though we are different, but still we are one. We shall study more about this, that is unity in diversity, later in the chapter. When you continue the chapter, you will learn about the unity more. Okay? Reasons of diversity. Traditions. Human beings prefer to live in groups. Look at your own house. You will see you live with your family. The family may be part of a joint family. The family lives in a house, the house in a colony, the colony is in locality, and the locality is in district, and district is in the state, and the state is in a country. So at every level, the people around you make a difference to how you live. So traditions. We know that we live in group, never alone. You are living in a family, maybe a joint family or nuclear family. Then you are, your family is in a colony, in a locality. Locality is in one district. District comes into a state. Then there is a lot of difference. For example, your parents teach you what you eat, how to eat, what to wear, how to pray, what to do, what not to do. Inside the house and outside the house, they learn these things from their parents and elders around them. This is what builds traditions and trends. From where the traditions came, your parents have learned from their parents and they are teaching you. Regional differences. You must have noticed that people of different places wear different clothes. If you go to Kashmir, they wear different clothes. In Rajasthan, they wear different clothes. If you go to South, they have different clothes. So what clothes we wear and how we wear them are also influenced by what people around us wear. So whatever clothes we are wearing, we wear according to the people who live near us. And what type of clothes they wear, we wear accordingly. Like if I am from South, and if I have settled in UP, I will be wearing clothes what people wear in UP. I will adjust with that. In some regions, the men wear turbans, in some wear caps, and in some they wear lungis or dhotis. Most of our dresses and food habits have come from our ancestors. So whatever food habits we have, clothes we wear, that all has come from our ancestors. Those who lived in hot areas wore headgear like a turban so as to save their head from the scorching heat. So those who live in Rajasthan and all, you must have seen, they are wearing a turban type so that they can save their head from the scorching heat or sun. Similarly, the people who lived in the areas which get a lot of rain wear clothes which are normally kept knee length so they do not get wet when walking through the waterlogged areas, rice field, etc. And if you will notice, the people who are living in very high rainfall areas, they wear very short clothes up to knee length so that their clothes do not get wet into the water when they are coming in the rice field or waterlogged area. So they wear knee length dresses. So that is regional differences. So they wear clothes according to the conditions of the place. Okay. And we adjust our clothes according to the place where we go and live. Food pattern. The availability of food in particular region also sets a pattern of food preferences. The plains of Punjab used to grow more wheat, so people ate more chapatis. So whatever habit we have got of eating food depends what type of food cultivation is there in the area. So our food pattern depends on the whatever particular region is cultivating. Like in Punjab, people eat more chapatis because Punjab grows more of wheat. Those areas near like Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, Bengal, they grow rice. So people became their rice eaters. Those who stayed in dry region like Rajasthan, where grain like bajra was grown, they started eating bajra, chapati and all. So our food habits have come from whatever was available in the region. So UP and Punjab, more of wheat was grown, so chapatis are eaten. In the South, Tamil Nadu, Kerala or Andhra Pradesh, these areas, they grow more of rice, so people eat rice. And in Rajasthan, people eat bajra. So those close to seas and rivers started eating fish. And others who did not have much of the agriculture produce around them, they became more and more meat eaters. So all our food habit depended on the food available to us in our region. Those who are living in the areas where there is no agriculture, they ate more of meat. Okay, those who live near the coastal area, sea area, they ate more of fish because fish was available, like in Kerala and all. With the passing of time, such dresses and food pattern became traditions as which relate to the people from the region or religion. Religious belief. Religion over a period has been a big binding force among people. Different people believe in different forms of God. They have different faiths and follow different rituals and customs. We all know we have lots of different religions. Some are Hindu, some Muslim, some Sikh, so many others. Some different customs we have, different rituals we have. They have different pattern of prayer, and all this leads to them to be living different ways of life. And our life becomes so different because we follow different religion. Our customs, rituals, pattern of prayer, everything is different. The Hindus go to temple, Sikh go to Gurudwara, Muslims go to mosque, and the Christians go to church. That is our difference in religious belief. Characteristics of diversity in India. So what are the characters or what are the diversities in India? The regional differences have brought about many peculiar characteristics and diversity differences we see every day around us in India. Let us see them one by one. First we will see different languages in India. Languages. Indian Constitution has recognized 22 principal languages. Languages have come into prominence from different regions. People in different parts of India speak different languages, like Punjabi in Punjab, Bengali in West Bengal, Tamil in Tamil Nadu, Telugu in Andhra Pradesh, Kannada in Karnataka, Malayalam in Kerala, Marathi in Maharashtra, Hindi in most part of central India, including Madhya Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh, Haryana, and so on. So India has lots and lots of languages, but Indian Constitution recognizes 22 principal languages, and we have different regional languages, as I told you. In Punjab, Punjabi, in Bengal, Bengal, West Bengal, you have Bengali, in Tamil Nadu, Tamil, Malayalam, in Kerala, and Hindi is in Uttar Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, Haryana, and so on. But the script of all different languages remains the same. They are spoken in different forms in different regions. For example, Punjabi spoken in Amritsar region of Punjab is quite different than the Punjabi in Ferozepur region. These variation in languages are called dialects. In India, there are more than 500 dialects of different languages. So we have different languages, but those languages also are different. For example, in Punjab, people speak Punjabi, but Punjabi is also of different type. In Amritsar, people speak Punjabi is quite different, and if you go to Firozpur, the people speak different Punjabi there. So these are called, these differences, this variation in one language is called as dialects. So we have more than 500 dialects in India spoken, different languages. Okay, so students, we have completed today chapter 1's some part. We have learned about the meaning of diversity, what is unity, food pattern, languages, religious belief, and religion. Tomorrow we will continue the chapter. Thank you.